In this video, I want to show you how you can use math short answer and add it to the Schoology assessments. So as you can see, I'm in an assessment. Over on the left, I'm going to go down to math short answer. Once this opens, you will see that you have the ability right here to start adding your question. Now, once you click inside here, you will start to see that you have the ability here to add more complex functions for algebra, trig, and that sort of thing. You can still do simple questions, so I'm just going to do, let's just do 5 times 2 equals. All right, and I'm going to say OK. So there it is going to put that question in for me. Now, down here below, these are some text formatting options for students. You may decide they really don't need to be able to bold. I could get rid of these if I don't need them. I can always add more if I do need to give them the ability to add a superscript or a subscript. I can actually change this one to subscript if that's what I really need. So I can give them that. And then here is the types of keyboards that are going to be available. This is the basic math, and this is the text keyboard. If I decide I need another one, I'm going to add another option, and here, like maybe I need to give them the algebra keyboard. So I can give them as many keyboards as I would like them to have access to. Okay, now default mode here is for which keyboard it's going to kind of land on, that basic math or the text to start with. Don't worry about having to change this. They can toggle between whichever keyboards they need. This is just the one that will be showing when they first open the question. Text boxes, let's say that you need them to add like centimeter and things like that on your question, so you can add more if you need to. This prevents them from having to flip off of if they're on the math keyboard and they need to tell you that it was 10 centimeters, then they can just quickly type that and not have to keep switching over to the text keyboard. All right, so that would be good to use if you know they're going to be needing lots of those abbreviations or whatever. And then down here for author notes is where you could just give a note to yourself and about what the answer is if you need to remember what the answer is going to be. Okay, and then as always you can come down here and add your learning objectives. So let's look at what this question looks like for the students. I'm going to go to preview question, and as you can see it's right here. So now when the student is ready to answer, they just click inside and see what they get. There's that basic calculator, and here is that algebra calculator. They can switch if they need to get to a text keyboard, and I said calculator, but it's actually a keyboard. All right, so they can switch the keyboards to whichever one they need to see and be in if they need to. Okay. All right, so then I'm going to, oops, let me go back and answer that. So the answer is 10, and there we go. And so then they just say save, and they go on. So that is how you add a math short answer. Oh, you also need to know that you will have to manually grade these by hand. It will not grade it for you. Thanks for watching.